Benthamukkar classification. The Benthamukkar's scientist year. It is Bentham and Hooker scientist. They wrote one book about the classification of plants. Genera Plantarum. Genera Plantarum book written by Bentham and Hooker. Bentham and Hooker scientist. The main features of these classification. The Bentham-Hooker classification of main features. This system includes names and descriptions of all genera of the seeds, plants known so far and classified accordingly. This system divided seed plants into 97,205 species under 202 families, 202 order and families. They divide seed plants into three classes in sequences: dicotyledon, gymnosperm and monocotyledon. Dicots divided into three divisions and 14 series. On the basis of the natural and visualized characteristics which provide key for the identification. Dicots started with family Ranunculaceae having free sepals and petals and indefinite number of stamens and carpels. The stamens and carpels are free, whereas it end with labiate having fused sepals and petals with definite number of carpels and stamens. Among monocots, out of seven series with epigynous flowers, that is orchidaceous and simultaneous, cytaminal, where the kept first and second respectively followed by with petaloid hypogynous flowers and finally end with Graminaceae and Cyperaceous. These are the main features of the Bentham and Hooker's classifications. This system divided seed plants into 97,205 species under 202 families or orders. 202 families. They divided seed plants into three major classes. They are dicotyledons, gymnosperms, and monocotyledons. The dicots divided into three divisions and 14 series. Based on the natural characters, visualized characters, and the dicots start with Ranunculaceae and end with labiate. Ranunculaceae containing sepals and petals are free and indefinite number of stamens and carpels, and they are free. The labiate family, sepals and petals are fused, the definite number of carpels and stamens. Among the monocots, the seven series with epigynous flowers, Orchidaceae, Cytaminal were kept first and second respectively followed by with petaloid hypogynous flowers. Finally, end with Graminaceae and Cyperaceous. So these are the main features of the classification of Benthamukkar's. Now, Benthamukkar classification is based on the three flower positions. Mainly in flowering plants, the flowers are three types. One is hypogynous flowers, second one is perigynous flower, third one is epigynous flower. Hypogynous flower shows superior ovary, means ovary present superior position of the flowers, flower parts. Here it is calyx, corolla, and rostrum, gynostium. These are the four major parts. From these four major parts, superior part is ovary, called superior ovary. The superior ovary present in the hypogynous flowers. And see here it is half superior or half inferior. Here it is half superior or half inferior. The flowers are shows perigynous. Perigynous means in these flowers, hypanthodium, hypanthium is present. The hypanthium, lateral side of these ovary, calyx, corolla, androecium are developed. The calyx and corolla, androeciums are developed on hypanthium. It is developed from the lateral side of the ovary. These types of flowers are called perigynous flowers. The perigynous flower shows half superior ovary or half inferior ovary. And next, last one is flower of epigynous. Epigynous flower shows inferior ovary. Inferior ovary means hypanthium is present around these ovary. Hypanthium is present and above the ovary, calyx, corolla, androeciums are developed. This type of ovary is present, inferior ovary present in the epigynous. See children, from these three types of flowers, three types of ovary positions, Benthamukkar classified plants in the genera Plantarum. Here it is. The plant kingdom mainly shows two major groups of plants. One is Cryptogamia, second one is Phanerogamia. Cryptogamia means non-flowering plants and Phanerogamia means flowering plants. Benthamukkar classified only flowering plants. Only flowering plants are classified into three classes. The three classes are Dicotyledonae, Gymnosperms, Gymnospermae, or Monocotyledonae. Third one, Monocotyledonae. The three classes are Dicotyledonae, Gymnospermae, Monocotyledonae. Dicotyledon class shows embryo contains or seed contain two cotyledons, leaves with reticulate venations, pentamerous or tetramerous flowers, tap root system present in the dicotyledons. And in the gymnosperm, seed enclosed with the seed cannot enclosed with fruit. Seed cannot enclosed with fruit. Fruits are absent in the gymnosperm. And in the monocotyledon, the cotyledons are embryo containing single cotyledon present in the embryo or present in the seed. Leaves with parallel venation and trimerous flowers, adventitious and fibrous root system present in the monocotyledonae. These are the external characters of these three classes. Now, Dicotyledonae class classified into three subclasses based on the arrangement of perianth. The three classes are Polypetalae, Gamopetalae, Monoclamidae. Polypetalae, Gamopetalae also called Diclamidae. Clamid means perianth. Perianth means calyx and corolla. Calyx and corolla are called perianth or clamid. In Polypetalae, two clamids are present. Outer clamid, outer perianth is called calyx. Inner perianth is called corolla. Corolla is free in position. Corolla is free in position. Flowers with both calyx and corolla in the Polypetalae. The petals are corolla free in the position. They cannot fused, free in position. In Gamopetalae, flowers with both calyx and corolla, but corolla fused. Corolla fused in the Gamopetalae. In Monoclamidae, clamids means perianth arranged in the single oral. The Monoclamidae major plants are sepaloids, means the calyx look like a sepals like structures. Sepals means calyx, calyx like structures. Now we discussed about the Polypetalae subclass. the polypetales subclass classified into three series based on the ovary position of the flower. Based on the ovary position of the flower, the polypetale subclass classified into three series. They are thalamiflorae, disciflorae, and calyciflorae. The thalamiflorae ovary is superior. Superior ovary is present in the thalamiflorae. And stamens, carpels are many. And the flowers are shows hypogynous flowers. Hypogynous flowers. Hypogynous flower shows superior ovary. The thalamiflorae containing thalamus structure or dome shaped or conical shaped structure present at the terminal part of the flower. The terminal part of the flower, thalamus. On this thalamus, flower parts are present. The flower parts are calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. These four major parts are present on the thalamus, dome-shaped thalamus or conical-shaped thalamus. The thalamiflorae series classified into six orders and 34 families. And the next one is disciflorae. Next series is disciflorae. The disciflorae series is disc-like structure present at the lower part of the florals. Means at lower part of calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium, disc-like structure is present. The disc-like structure containing nectaries. So nectary filled with disc present at the lower part of the floral parts. And the flowers are hypogynous. Hypogynous flowers, and the flower shows superior ovary. The disciflorae classified into four orders and 22 families. And the next last series of the polypetale, calyciflorae. Calyciflorae flowers are perigynous. The initial orders are perigynous and end orders are epigynous. Initial orders are perigynous. End orders are epigynous. Ovary half superior or half inferior at the initial families. But end families are inferior family, inferior ovary, inferior ovary. The calyciflorae classified into five orders and 27 families. And the next subclass is gamopetale. The gamopetale series, gamopetale subclass classified into three series. They are inferae, heteromerae, bicarpellate. Gamopetale means the flowers with both calyx and corolla. The corolla is fused. The fused corolla is called gamopetale. The gamopetale series classified into, gamopetale subclass classified into inferae series, heteromerae series, bicarpellate series. Inferae series. Inferae series means inferior ovary is present. Epigynous flowers with inferior ovary. Stamens are many. And petals alternate with stamens. Stamens are alternate with petals. Inferior ovary, epigynous flowers, stamens are many. They are alternate with petals. The inferae series classified into three orders and nine families. The next series is heteromerae. The heteromerae series shows hypogynous flowers. Stamens are two or more, orals. They are epipetales. They are epipetales, are free from the corolla. Carpels more than two, carpels are present in this series. The heteromerae classified into, heteromerae series classified into three orders and 12 families. In the last series of the gamopetale, bicarpellate. Bicarpellate means carpels are two, ovary superior, and stamens are many, and corolla are alternate with them. Means stamens are many, they are alternate with corolla. The bicarpal letter means only two carpels are present in the series. It classified into, there is classified into four orders and 23 families. The next one is Monochlamydae subclass. The Monochlamydae subclass, here it is. Monochlamydae means chlamids, means perianth. Perianth is the single oral. Flowers usually with one oral of perianth. The perianth commonly is sepaloid. Sepaloid means normally green in color. Petals are completely absent in the Monocotyledonae subclass. The Monocotyledonae subclass divided into or classified into series. They are Carvimbriae, Multi-ovulate Aquatici, Multi-ovulate Terrestri, Microembriae, Depenales, Achlamydosporae, Unisex Whales, Ordina Anomali. These are the series of Monochlamydae. The first series of Carvimbriae, and one more important point, the Monochlamydae direct classified into series. Series direct classified into families. Orders are absent in the Monochlamydae. So Carvimbriae means curved embryos are present. Curved embryos containing plants are placed in this series, Carvimbriae. It classified into six families. Multi-ovulate Aquatici, the name is given, multi-ovules are present in the flowers. That plants are developed in the aquatic regions. So multi-ovulate Aquatici plants are placed in the multi-ovulate Aquatici. It classified into only one family, multi-ovulate Terrestri. Multi-ovule containing plants, flowers, they are developed at the terrestrial region called multi-ovulate Terrestri. It classified into three families. And the fourth series is microembryo. The name is given, micro means small, embryo means embryo. Microembryo, small embryos are present in the flowers called microembryo. It classified into four families. Depenales. Depenales means the perianth. The perianth look like sepals, like petals like structures. Mainly the depenales classified into five families. Achlamydosporae. Achlamydosporae means chlamids are completely absent, means perianths are completely absent. It classified into three families. Unisex whales. Unisex means male and female flowers are developed on the plants. Unisexual flowers are developed in the plants called unisex whales. It classified into nine families. And last series is Ordina Anomali. Imperfect families, plants of Monochlamydae, they are placed in the Ordina Anomali. It classified into nine families. And the next class is Monochlamydae. The Monochlamydae containing four major external characters, monocotyledons. Monocotyledon containing four major external characters. They are one cotyledon in the seed and parallel venation of leaves, trimerous flowers, adventitious or fibrous root system present in the monocotyledons. The monocotyledons are classified into series. The series are Microsperme, Epigynae, Coronariae, Callicinae, Nudiflorae, Apocarpe, Glumaceae. Microsperme means the name given. Micro means small, sperm means seeds. Small seeds are developed in the monocotyledons. They are classified under the Microsperme series. The Microsperme series classified into three families. Epigynae, it is the next series of monocotyledon. Epigynae means epigynous in flowers, shows inferior ovary. The inferior ovary, epigynous flowers are placed in the Epigynae series of monocotyledon. It classified into seven families. Coronariae. The Coronariae classified into eight families. The Coronariae shows the perianth look like corolla. Corolla means perianth look like petals like structure. Corolla like structures, perianth are present in the flowers. That type of flower plants are placed in the Coronariae series. It classified into eight families. And the next series is Callicinae. The parent look like a sepaloid. Sepaloid means they are green in color, called Callicinae. It contain five families, means Callicinae classified into five families. Nudiflorae, naked flowers, stamens and androecums are naked in condition without calyx and corolla, called Nudiflorae. The Nudiflorae classified into five families. Apocarpae, carpels are in free position, called Apocarpae. Carpels are more in number. The more number of carpels are in free position, called Apocarpae. That Apocarpae flowering plants are classified under the monocotyledon of Apocarpae. It classified into three families. And the Gloomaceae. Gloomaceae is the last series of monocotyledon. Glooms like structures are present in the flowers. The glooms like structures are present in the flowers. That flowering plants are classified under the Gloomaceae series. It classified into five families. It is the external total characters of Bentham and Hooker's classification. And some merits and demerits also there in this classification. The merits are, they have provided keys to families, to orders. The creation of disky florae between Thalamiflorae and Callicinae. The treating Cucurbitaceae and Umbelliferae at end of the polypetale as connecting link between poly and gamopetalous families. The position of Heteromeres before bicarpellae. The creation of monocotyledon at end of the dicots. So these are the merits of the Bentham Hooker's classification. And the demerits are, so here it is. The demerits are, first demerit is, in polypetale, the flowers are classified, placed in the first series, Thalamiflorae containing hypogynous, Discylflorae containing hypogynous, and Callicinae beginning perigynous, end with epigynous. They followed is the system of classification, hypogynous, perigynous, epigynous. But they didn't follow in the same system of classification in the gamopetale. In gamopetale series, the first placed plants are epigynous. So epigynous plants are first placed in this gamopetale. It didn't follow based on the flower position or ovary position in the gamopetale. And the next one is monochlamydae and monocotyledons classified into series. The series directly classified into families. Yet it is orders are not classified in the series. And one more important point, between the dicotyledon and monocotyledon, why they placed of gymnosperms? It didn't explain the reasons of gymnosperm placed in the placed between the dicotyledons and monocotyledons. It is the classification merits and demerits of the Bentham Hooker classification. The gymnospermae classified into three families only, that is Cycadaceae, Coniferaceae, Neataceae.